communicated between you.
Right.
Hey, don't. It had to be communicated to you, who had the only person, the only parent who had the information that the child was sick. You texted, called, pigeoned, however you did it, communicated with the child's father that the child was sick. Now, after having him arrested, pay attention, because this is...
I'm ready.
You understand.
I'm
you understand what I'm saying to you?
Yeah.
What did you text him for? You either leave work and go to the daycare and pick up the child, or you call the other parent to say, I'm working. Can you pick him up? Those are the only two things that happened.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Which one was it?
Did you leave work? I couldn't leave work.
Fine.
Yes.
So you didn't leave work and you called him to pick up the child.
Yes.
That wasn't that easy. Instead of giving me all this baloney that you were giving me, we were texting back and forth, and then he said, no, you don't leave work. I'm not working. I'll leave work. Doesn't it make...
Okay.
That's not... Do you know what I'm talking about?
I asked him to go get him. Yeah,
that's right.
I couldn't leave
easy,
work.
Simple.
Yes.
You asked him to go get him, and he went and he got him, and he took him to...
Just a second.
I'm telling myself what her claim is, and what your claim is, that instead of taking him home, he took him to an emergency room.
He called an ambulance. He took him to urgent care, then called an ambulance. And everybody knows you don't do that. You take him straight to emergency because it costs too much out of pocket, but it's not on his insurance, it's on mine, and he knew ahead of time they were going to bill
me. Don't tell me what he knew. If what you're suing him for is because you think he used poor judgment, that's not a lawsuit.
But he
what I'm telling
made a
you.
Bill. He's personal. He's like purposely making bills for me. He's purposely making life harder for me since we've broken up. I know it's hard to see, but I've got a lot of things here.
A lot of police reports. Listen to me. I don't care.
I know.
You picked him. He has seven children.
He does.
Hey, just a second. He has seven children.
Yep, mine
you
makes
have
number seven.
You wanted one. Your clock was ticking.
Mm-hmm.
And it was time for you to have a baby.
Yep.
And you picked somebody who had seven children and, according to you, if I read your complaint, is very often out of work. So you were trying to make a silk purse out of a sow's ear. That's very hard. That's not on anybody but you.
Okay.
Yeah, so, just a second. You're living as a family. You don't get rent. If you call him to pick up the child, then you have to rely on his judgment. If you don't like his judgment, and if you have custody, don't call him again. His judgment was to take the child to urgent care and let urgent care call an ambulance to take him over to the hospital.
For a cold.
I don't. Listen to me.
All right.
I don't understand how the rent isn't applicable.
We broke up. He was still supposed to pay rent.
He owes you $180 for setting off the alarm. Now I'm entertaining his counterclaim. What did you do with his things?
Judge Judy continues in a moment. And later today,
the $770 came out of my bank.
Your heart.
You need.
The most important value.
Free investing class near you.
Would Shakespeare have chosen Jesse?
How to sue him for the value of his property.
What did you do with his things?
I put his things out.
Where?
Out on.